the years after the Civil War, many African Americans moved away from the South, escaping the Jim Crow laws and the more prevalent racism. By the early 20th century, many had congregated in the North, particularly Harlem, New York. The Harlem Renaissance was a major change in American culture, and famously led to the creation of jazz, a smooth, swung-time style of music that evolved out of the ragtime, meaning ragged time, an early version of swinging eighth notes, of the late 19th century. The Roaring Twenties were a time of massive change in the United States. The Great War was over, the economy was booming, and the list of new inventions grew longer every day. And in the streets of Harlem, New York, a new style took center stage for a new era of music. The Jazz Age. Woodwind instruments such as the clarinet and saxophone largely replaced the brass instruments of the previous eras, with the general exceptions of the trumpet and trombone. These instruments, along with the piano, were used in the new styles of music that were brought about by the younger African-American population in the North, many of whom had by this time not directly experienced Southern slavery. Prominent African-Americans made music listened to by both white and black people, not just in America, but around Europe as well. Many of the most famous artists of the era would not come to full prominence until the late 20s and early 30s, such as Billie Holiday. Jazz is a musical style based on the use of improvisation. Players often do solos, and as such it is very often to hear two different recordings of the same song have different musical interludes. Jazz evolved from ragtime in its instrumental musical style, but it took inspiration from the slave songs sung by the slaves in the South, showing that while the current generation of African Americans were no longer enslaved, they had not forgotten the wounds it left on their people. But they were able to take their old songs about escaping bondage and making it to the North, and use them to make new songs that significantly helped them lighten the chains of racism that still remained very heavy at that time, even in the North. Black Americans were considered below white Americans, even if they were free. It's not clear where the word jazz came from. Early spellings had it J-A-S or J-A-S-S, although it was probably still pronounced loosely the same. Also during this time, a new style of poetry was emerging that took inspiration from jazz, exemplified by African-American poet Langston Hughes. This style was spoken words, not sung, with jazz instruments such as the tenor sax in the background. While not technically music in and of itself, the new style of poetry helped spread the ideas of jazz and popularize the instrumentation.
Good evening. Tonight, Mr. Langston Hughes, American poet, dramatist, novelist, lyricist, lecturer. He's in town to give a lecture at UBC, but he's here tonight to read poetry, his own poetry, to a jazz accompaniment. We have Alan Miller to interview him. We have Doug Parker and his band to provide the jazz, and Mr. Langston Hughes has his own accompaniment, his own introduction.
Suns are setting. This is what I'm gonna sing. Suns are setting. This is what I'm gonna sing. I feel the blues are coming. I wonder what the blues will bring. Drowsy, syncopated tune, rocking back and forth to a mellow croon. I heard a Negro play. Down on Lenox Avenue the other night, by the pale, dull pallor of a one-bulb light, he did a lazy sway. He did a lazy sway. to the tune of those weary blues. With his ebony hands and each ivory key, he made that poor piano moan with melody. Oh, blues. Swaying to and fro on his rickety stool, he played that sad, raggy tune like a musical fool. Sweet blues, coming from a black man's soul. Oh, blues. In a deep song voice with a melancholy tone, I heard that Negro sing. That old piano moan. Ain't got nobody in all this world. Ain't got nobody but myself. I'm going to quit my frowning and put my troubles on the shelf. Thump, 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 when he's put on the floor. He played a few chords, then he sang some more. I got the weary blues, I can't be satisfied. Got the weary blues, I can't be satisfied. I ain't happy no more, and I wish that I had died.
Another genre common to the era was the blues. The blues were a slower genre, rather melancholy, and sung about melancholy things. The style was rather less popular than jazz in the upbeat and active Roaring Twenties, but became emblematic of the Great Depression, along with slow jazz. The beauty of a style based around improvisation is that it can adapt to the times, whether they are good or very bad. Most likely, the term the blues came from the Blue Devils, which was used to mean that somebody was very, very drunk and completely and totally out of it. Shortly after the end of the Roaring Twenties, there was another new style of music, swing. It was an upbeat and active genre, to which one was intended to dance. It was mostly orchestral, and one of the most well-known artists of the time was Duke Ellington, the King of Swing. He had made music throughout the 20s, but at the time it wasn't really differentiated from normal jazz. By the 1930s, however, it had become known as its own thing, and was wildly popular. The primary differentiation was the use of big bands, a sort of small orchestra. Some of the songs did include vocals, such as Don't Mean a Thing If It Ain't Got That Swing, which was sung by Ella Fitzgerald, another popular artist of the time.
The Duke and Ella, so let's have a wonderful...
Don't mean a thing if it ain't got that swing. Do-a, 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 do-a. It don't mean a thing, all you gotta do is sing. Do-a, 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 do-a.
Perhaps the greatest artist of the 20s and 30s was the legendary Louis Armstrong. His gravelly voice and beautiful trumpet were beloved by American and European audiences. He created many songs that are still popular today, such as What a Wonderful World, and some that have stuck around but are less common on the radio, such as When the Saints Go Marching In. He was a famous figure up until his death, but he was not without controversies. Some African Americans were jealous of his success and considered him a sellout, while his stage persona was occasionally likened to an Uncle Tom, a stereotype of a black man who was happy to serve white masters. He and many of the black artists of the time faced major obstacles to their success, many of these struggles stemming from racism, particularly when touring. For example, Armstrong's reviews from his opening tour in Europe included such praise as mentioning his rhythmic jungle roar. The Billie Holiday song, Strange Fruit, was a piece about the lynchings of African Americans, which left their bodies hanging from the trees by a noose, something that is increasingly rare today, but even now still happens. The song itself is sung in an ugly manner. Her voice is strained and hoarse, and the horror and sadness at the practice is evident. All of this music has had a massive and incalculable impact on America, and many of the songs from these times are still hugely popular today. It is fair to say that without this music, the United States and the world as a whole would be far worse off without it.
Thank you. southern breeze. Strange fruit hanging from the poplar trees. Pastoral scene of the gallant south.
This is my works cited page. I've cited popular music and jazz, authentic or ersatz, from the American Stravinsky, The Style and Aesthetics of Copland's New American Music, The Early Works, 1921 to 1938, from the University of Michigan Press in 2012. I obtained this one from the JSTOR. Joplin Biography, from scottjoplin.org. Not a Wonderful World, Why Louis Armstrong Was Hated by So Many, from The Guardian. Cited the official Billie Holiday website, History of Ragtime, from the Library of Congress, The Mysterious Origins of Jazz, from BBC Culture, and What is Jazz, from the National Museum of American History. I've also cited a number of different songs that I used in this video, including West End Blues by Louis Armstrong and Earl Hines, Nobody Knows You When You're Down and Out by Bessie Smith, Riff in the Scotch by Billie Holiday, It Don't Mean a Thing If It Ain't Got That Swing by Ella Fitzgerald and Duke Ellington, Duke Ellington and His Orchestra, Bundle of Blues, Langston Hughes' The Weary Blues was the poem included, and Billie Holiday's Strange Fruit at the end. I've also cited a video called Duke Ellington, The Swing Era, 1920s, from which I obtained an amount of my information about swing.